What's up, guys? Amoch is finally back in the game. And today we're playing Life is Strange Before the Storm. It's the bonus episode farewell. It comes out when I play it today. I hope that I can upload it for tomorrow for you guys to see. So, why did I say finally back? Well, I was sick. You probably can still hear it, and I want to apologize upfront for coughing during the recording. It will happen, most probably. So, I was sick and I couldn't record for a little bit of more than a week. I'm still not fully recovered, but I really want to play this today. I was waiting for it for months and I just can't wait for it. You'll see me a little shaving accident happened, like it was a little bit too short. But yeah, it will grow back. I will look like an adult in 2 weeks, probably again. I mean, I look like fucking 16. I'm getting 30 soon, like next year. For fuck's sake. Alright. Anyway, I'm so looking forward to play this, and without further ado, we will head into it. This is starting off really cool.
Ready, I guess. But isn't your mom gonna freak? She's probably cooking with the radio on. She won't hear a thing. I bet she'll notice a hole in the floor. Trust in science, Max. Even when science means blowing shit up.
Everything for science. No.
Tell me that wasn't the coolest thing you've ever seen.
That was amazing.
That was truly amazing. Why are explosions so awesome? That's like asking, why are puppies cute? Some things just are. I'm not sure your mom would see it that way. When she asked me to get rid of my old junk, she never specified how. But I guess I better do some actual cleaning too. I'll be excavating the closet. If you see anything else to trash, help a girl out and chuck it on the pile over there.
Sure.
It feels like I've spent half my life hanging out in this room. Probably because I have. I can't believe those days are all over now. Chance to say goodbye. But how do you tell your best friend that you're leaving her?
Bonus episode farewell. Fucking coughing. Destroys all the mood.
I better help Chloe with her cleaning.
Yeah, we should definitely help her with her cleaning.
I can take one long. Let this box of trash be a sacrifice to you, oh almighty Chloe Bear.
Nope.
Chloe and I haven't played this game in forever, and I'm pretty sure it's missing pieces.
I don't want to trash anything.
This was our first unsupervised concert together. It was so much fun. We were supposed to see another show next month, but...
How sick was that show?
The sickest.
I've been working on my moves for the next one. Check it out. How about you? Any new moves?
Totally.
Yeah, totally. I've been working on my air guitar.
Damn, Caulfield. Save something for when it counts. All right, back to the junk mines.
Should we trash this? I think we should.
What are you doing?
Adding this to the pile.
No freaking way. Just because I beat your ass every time we play doesn't make it trash.
You beat me. Are you sure?
That's BS. The last time we played, I wiped the floor with you.
Poor Max. Losing your memory at such a young age. Guess we'll have to play again soon and find out.
Alright.
Chloe's always preferred imaginary animals to real ones. Chloe's mom wanted us to go through this pile of old clothes and find stuff to donate. Instead, we played dress up for an hour.
Well, of course.
Chloe's had this hung up on her wall forever, but neither of us can figure out what happened to the last panel. I hope Dr. Kloenstein's okay.
Our crime fighting has really soared since you created those rocket boosters. Of course, the power of flight does tend to make things easier. Dr. Kloenstein? Well, I would like to know what happened to. What do we have here?
Whoa. Talk about embarrassing.
Well, I think that's for the pile. Yep, that's definitely for the trash pile.
How about these boy band trading cards? Super cringeworthy.
Yeah, and hilarious. Remember when we gave them all makeovers?
Shoppy boob jobs.
You mean when you drew boobs on all of them? I was so mad at you.
And yet, our friendship lived on. So too will these cards.
That's not how it works. You have to throw something away.
Chloe keeps trying to get me to hop on her board. I'd rather take... Chloe's such a nerd. She hangs on to all her old textbooks and school supplies. Chloe's had this hoodie for years. It's her favorite. I don't think she'd mean to throw it away. I can't help you if you won't trash anything.
I'll trash some stuff. Just not the stuff you found.
Uh-huh.
Let's save this.
What are you doing?
Your favorite hoodie. You must have thrown it in by mistake, right?
No. It's fine. It's filled with holes and falling apart.
That never stopped you from wearing it before.
It's fine. Really.
Are you sure? I don't know. Let's look in there.
We bought this as a gag years ago. I honestly can't believe Chloe still has it.
I don't want to trash it, but we have to trash something.
What about this hack-eaten jawbreaker? A serious biohazard.
You promised me we'd finish it together no matter how long it took. Don't be a quitter.
Lick it.
You're right.
Yes! The never-ending candy lives on.
Okay, whenever I'm ready, I can go tell Chloe I'm done arguing about trash with her. Chloe's been beating me for a while, but that growth spurt could come any day now.
Yep, I'm telling myself the same for like, I don't know, 15 years?
I think Chloe used to call this guy Mr. Sharky.
Mr. Sharky.
I doubt she plays with it anymore.
You better not be thinking what I think.
All right.
I haven't seen you touch this guy in years. Why do you care?
Why do I care? If you throw my beloved childhood friend into the trash? I don't think that deserves an answer.
Sorry, chum.
That's better.
How could we think about this? Seriously.
That was awesome.
It was.
Who else but Chloe could turn cleaning her room into a pyrotechnical adventure? People say a lot of things about the Prescott family, but this is pretty cool.
What did they do? I don't remember, to be honest.
I bet Chloe's parents were freaking out when she got this letter.
All right, yeah. She was accepted.
I still can't believe you're a Blackwell Academy student. How is it?
Oh, the classes are incredible. The teachers are actually smart. And the lab is legit. Petri dishes for days.
What about the students? Are they as stuck up as you thought they'd be?
They're fine.
Come on, let's push a little bit.
Chloe, you're terrible at hiding your feelings. Is everything okay?
I don't know, I like hanging out with normal people. Like you.
Thanks. I guess.
You know what I mean. I hate fake people. You're real.
Thanks.
Thanks. That actually means a lot.
Hey, what's your dad's camera doing in here?
Dad said I could bring it up here for you to use. He's tired of watching you drool all over yourself every time he uses it. His words.
Your dad is the best.
Sure. Just don't ever tell him that. We need to keep him on his toes. You're off to a great start.
Actually, it's kind of cool.
Menagerie of magic.
I was lucky to survive Chloe's magic phase with all my fingers intact.
This seems like a good candidate. Are you insane? That's my entire magic collection. Do you know how many weeks of allowance this cost?
I never use it.
You haven't touched these since the 5th grade talent show.
Maybe because my assistant turned out to be squeamish at the sight of fake blood.
At least you didn't saw me in half. How are you planning to clean this place if you won't throw away anything?
A magician never reveals her secrets. Put it back.
That's not how it works. Not at all. I wanted to take a picture of her.
As usual, Chloe's grades are better than mine. I still kick her butt in PE, though.
Holy shit, she was an A student. I genuinely wasn't aware of that. Oh no. Oh no, no, no. That wasn't planned. Alright.
It's so hard to believe.
Take a break.
This room, this house, this town.
We didn't do anything, but let's take a break.
Now. Or soon to be. Who even am I without Chloe? She's the one who's always starting things, pulling us into adventures. I can't imagine life without her. Maybe I haven't told her I'm leaving yet because I still can't believe it's real myself.
Let's get up. I could listen to this soundtrack all fucking day. Seriously. Alright. Alright. Oh, nice. We're through. We did it. She didn't throw away one thing that we showed her, but well, I knew that up front.
I'm calling off the search. If you want more trash, you'll have to find it yourself.
Well, it wasn't exactly the purge Mom was hoping for, but at least we tried, right?
Right.
And now we've got the whole day ahead of us. What do two undersupervised friends with clean rooms and clean slates want to get into today?
Clean rooms?
I guess now would be a good time to tell Chloe I'm leaving. Or I could let us enjoy the day first and tell her later.
I don't want to make that decision, to be honest. We should tell her now. In the end, we will meet someone outside and they will tell her, and then she's pissed at us because we didn't tell her first. Let's tell her now, really. And try to enjoy the day afterwards.
Actually, Chloe, I really have to tell you something. I don't know how
Holy
to...
Shit! Max, hold that thought. This must have fallen out when I was digging around in here. Do you have any idea what this is?
It's pirate related. Ah, come on. Fucking Steam.
Whatever it is, it looks like it came out of our pirate phase.
Your powers of deduction are as strong as ever. This tape is from 5 years ago. It's a message from our past selves to our current selves.
So we were 8 years old? That's crazy. I can't even imagine what we sounded like.
Ready to find out?
The audio log of the most fearsome pirates in the bays of Arcadia. Captain Bluebeard and Long Mac Silver.
We were such dorks.
So, you're in search of buried treasure, are ye? Well, if it's treasure ye seek,
mine eyes spot two fair pirate wenches. What?
Dad, get away! We're in the middle of an important project.
Oh, a project. Never mind then. I apologize.
I mean it!
All right. Supper's in five. Wash your hands, you grubby pirate kids.
So lame. As I was saying, if it's treasure you seek, you've come to the right place. But be forewarned, the journey will be treacherous and full of treachers.
Nice.
To find the treasure of Price Isle, you will need the map from the manuscripts of Captain Bluebeard. Only the map can lead ye to the treasure ye seek. But be forewarned. Again, only those with pure hearts will be able to see what the amulet shows them.
The amulet.
Good luck. And, why?
Dude. That was
hilarious.
Hilarious. We were so, so ridiculous.
We still are, Max. We still are. Okay, forget everything. Today, we go treasure hunting. I think I know what 8-year-old you meant by the manuscripts of Captain Bluebeard.
Our old sketchbook. This is where we kept all our pirate drawings.
Yep. Now let's see this map.
Property of Captain Bluebeard and Long Max Silver. Keep out, Mom. The Bane of Arcadia, Crow's Nest Saloon, Cockpit Gallery, I think? Or Galley? What? Plank, Treasure Keep, Cannons. Cannons are important. Those two. Pogo the Pirate. The gang. Pirate rules. No bathing, no boys on the ship. No sharing pirate secrets. Always share plunder. Always bury treasure. Always protect fellow pirates. Failure to obey these rules will result in plank walking. And Captain's log.
This looks like a page was ripped out.
It looks like
it. I wonder if it's the map.
Probably. I'm too lazy to read this right now, to be honest. I'm sorry. I have to interrupt this coughing at least 5 times.
Hey, check this out. This page was ripped out. Do you think it's the map?
If it is, there's no way I would have thrown it out. Maybe it's mixed in with the rest of the drawings?
So much for telling Chloe now. All she cares about is finding this map. Don't move. This angle is perfect.
Why be shy? Get in here.
Let's pose with her.
Subject and photographer. You really do it all, Max.
I try.
Yay! Got the first picture!
I remember writing this. It's a story where you choose what happens. Wonder if I could still get to the end.
Let's see! You are Max and Chloe! Best friends and students in school. You sit in class until suddenly a cute squirrel arrives at the window. It's so cute. We want to pet it. Pet the squirrel, page 8. Don't pet the squirrel, page 3. Of course we pet the squirrel. You go to the window and pet the squirrel. Of course, why wouldn't you? It's a cute squirrel and you want to pet it. Hey, Mr. Squirrel, you say. Stop biting me, you say next, because the squirrel is now biting your hand. That makes sense. But it's too late, you have rabies. Mrs. Anders has to shoot you so you don't bite anyone else. This makes her very sad. Guess you shouldn't have pet the squirrel. Alright, so much for that. God fucking damn it.
People say a lot of things about the press.
Alright, yeah, we heard this already.
This is pretty cool. This looks like a page was ripped out. I wonder if it's... Chloe's so determined to find the map. I love any luck.
Nope. You?
Nothing yet.
It's not here. Or is it in there? Holy shit.
Oh, yes. Take that, Rat King.
Yes. I made it. I have no idea. Because I just flipped through the whole fucking book. But apparently I did it.
Chloe and I were doing a lot of drawing in Miss Shelley's class. I wonder if the map is mixed in with her school supplies from that year.
People say a lot of things about the Prescott family, but this is pretty cool.
I thought I can check her school supplies.
Chloe and I were doing a lot of drawing in Shelley's class. I wonder if the map is mixed
with
school supplies from that year.
Look at that. Got it.
Bingo.
Where do we start? Chloe's secret lair, dark cavern. There's an amulet there. Treasure Island and Price Castle.
I'm remembering this now. Didn't we make some crazy puzzle? You need the telescope and the amulet,
which we hid inside a dark cavern, aka the attic.
Ugh, why did we do that to ourselves?
Because we were 8 years old and the attic was the scariest place we could think of.
Is it still scary?
Was. Your attic is still terrifying.
It's been 5 years, Max. I'm sure the boogeyman has died of starvation.
It's more the mice and spiders I'm afraid of.
Time to face your fears, then.
Okay, and once we have the amulet and the telescope, we use them to reveal the treasure. Somehow.
Here's what's happening. I'll head to the garage to dig up my old telescope. You go find that amulet. We'll meet out back at the pirate ship.
Why do I have to go to the attic?
Swings?
Yes, the pirate ship. Captain Bluebeard and Long Max Silver right again, bitches!
I'll find a way to tell Chloe later. If this has to be my last day here, might as well have one final pirate adventure.
It's her last day and she still didn't tell her. I don't think that's very nice.
Chloe said she hid the amulet in the attic. The only way in
is probably through the broom closet.
There it is, the dark cavern. Crap. I can't get into the attic if I can't even reach the door. I need to find something to stand on. I'm sure I can find something around here to boost me up.
Alright, let's use the crate. Then we should be able to reach it. And enter the scary attic. Or are we still too short? Still too short.
It's a start. I gotta find something I can stack on top of it.
A tool works.
It seems like Chloe's dad always has a project around the house. Makeup is great for acting in Halloween costumes. Any other time, I just don't get it. I guess Chloe never really grew out of wanting to be a pirate. Chloe's mom bought me a toothbrush because I spend the night here so often. Well, I used to.
That's so sad.
The things inside this cabinet haven't changed very much over the years.
Alright. We need something to stack. What can we use?
Just need a few more inches.
All right. What else? Yep, the books. But first, first First, we'll check this out.
I always like to imagine I could open that wardrobe and step into another world. I don't think I could ever handle a real-life murder investigation.
Objection. You do.
The Two Whales makes the best Belgian waffles. No other diner could even come close. Aw, Chloe's parents are so cute. Chloe's mom is trying to quit smoking. Principal at Blackwell wants to meet with Chloe's parents. I wonder what about. Did Chloe get into a fight? Is she in a voicemail? I wonder if it's still there. Sometimes I really wish I had siblings.
Are you sure?
Chloe hasn't mentioned a trip. Maybe it's supposed to be a surprise. Chloe is such a nature nerd. I bet she's gonna love it. Most strikes? How can that be so cool and so dorky at the same time? It's awesome that Chloe's mom wants to teach kids. She'd be really good at it.
Alright. We gotta move on.
That should be tall enough.
That should be tall enough. Let's climb and please don't break your neck. There's the amulet.
Chloe hid the amulet in the hardest place.
Right, need to get the amulet.
I remember it took this thing like 100 years to rewind the land before time.
Let's move the chair. Come on, hasn't anyone been up there since 5 years?
I can squeeze through now.
Right, we almost got it. Almost there.
I remember this. Chloe refused to get another goldfish after she had that's full of decorations Chloe made when she was 5. It's a good thing I'm big and burly. Otherwise, moving this furniture would be kind of difficult.
I guess.
Keep it moving. Crap. Guess you have to go back.
All right. Now, one thing after another.
Not a single country record. These must belong to Chloe's mom. I need to move that cooler, but this desk is in the way.
How do we pull this? For fuck's sake. This fucking coughing is so annoying.
One step closer.
Alright, now we can push the desk. So I really hope that I can edit out all the fucking coughing, but...
this desk's pretty heavy.
If I forget one, please bear with me. Right, now.
Glad this thing is empty.
All right, the way is free.
Yes.
Finally. There it is.
A fitting reward for a journey full of treasures. Got you. This thing is cool, I guess. I wish I could remember how it works. Chloe Price, my best friend. It's so weird being back in this attic after so long. I remember being terrified of this place. I think when you're a kid, you're only afraid of things that can hurt you. But when you get older, you become more afraid of hurting the people you care about. And spiders.
Ha ha! I have you now, scallywag.
Man, I'm gonna miss her.
All right, we can't sit here forever. We gotta move.
Are you just watching me up there, Creeper?
You are one of a kind, Chloe Price.
What?
I'm lucky you're my best friend. That's all.
Damn right you are, you mushy weirdo. You find the amulet? Awesome. Now get your ass down here. We have treasure to find.
On my way.
Dude, you did it!
No big deal.
Bring the amulet over here so I can see.
Chloe is so excited. I better bring her the amulet before she makes me walk the plank. All I'm saying is, I've never broken my wrist taking a picture.
Well,
I'm really gonna miss Price family barbecues. I wish this was big enough to jump in.
It's only September. It'll be totally dive bombable in a few weeks.
Yeah, a few weeks.
Why didn't you tell her before, like, in time, and not on the last fucking day?
Chloe and I have done lots of homework at this table.
Girl, that is really, really unfortunate.
It's not that I don't like the blue. I'm just sad to see the old color go. One time, we stuck a bunch of this tape to Chloe's face to make a blue beard. Putting it on was a lot more fun than taking it off.
Well,
this was a fun experiment. I'm almost surprised we actually managed to grow something. Poor Bongo. Chloe took his death so hard.
Who was Bongo?
I guess Chloe's mom comes all the way back here to smoke. I still wish I could live in the world we drew. I've spent so much of my life here. Every little corner is familiar. Comforting. These games we're playing. Buried pirate treasure from our past selves. Is this all selfish of me? Why is this making me feel more guilty about leaving? How am I going
to... What's up, dude?
Bro.
Don't you mean sis?
Maybe I meant nerd. Dork. Doofus.
Only doofuses say doofus. You know what, Max Caulfield?
What, Chloe Price?
You're the frickin' best. That's all.
You're damn right.
Damn right. About time you realized it.
Just tell anyone and I'll deny it. Okay, enough of this shit. There's treasure to be unburying.
That was so cute.
This thing looks so much smaller than I remember. I can't believe Chloe still has it. Actually, after this morning, I can.
Oh well.
I never understood why it's called a Jolly Roger. How jolly can you be if you're dead?
Glider swings. The best way to simulate a storm on the high sea.
Wait just a minute.
I could have taken a photo.
Yarr!
You I must missed ask it.
Permission before setting foot or peg on another captain's boat.
Permission to come aboard, Captain Bluebeard?
Granted.
One amulet coming right up.
Okay, I think it goes. Damn it. I forget how to make this. Stay on.
Stay here. I think I saw some tape.
Thanks, Max.
Just some tape left between us and the...
Hey, Chloe.
Yar.
Walk the plank.
Walk the plank.
Perfect.
All right, let's get the tape.
Score. One step closer to getting that treasure. Whatever it is.
Yep, we have to get the treasure.
Avast, matey. Have you brought me prize?
Ahoy, Bluebeard. I have brought the stickiest tape in all the seven seas.
Well done, fellow scallywag.
Just like old times. Huh, Max?
Remember how we used to talk about ruling the bays of Arcadia one day? We thought we were gonna be pirates forever.
I guess we grew out of it. But I It's fun to act like kids again. For a little while.
Yeah. Would you like to do the honors, Long Max Silver?
Me? Are you sure?
Of course. Come on, Navigator. Point me to some treasure.
Wait, how am I supposed to use this?
The drawing on the lens. It should line up with something?
Here goes nothing. Okay, this drawing is supposed to line up with something.
All right, I know. Hold on. Hold on. Where's the freaking... Hold on.
The angle almost looks right.
Ah. Haha! Now we got it! That's it!
Got it! Yes! You rock! Where is it? Here?
A little bit to your right,
okay.
To my right.
Take a step right.
No!
No, the other right!
My other right or your other right?
Your other right.
Your other right! Sure thing. Wait, what?
Just go that way. Perfect. Now come towards me.
There it is.
Bingo.
Now I'm really curious what they dug in there.
What the?
That is not what we buried.
What? Is this?
I don't know. Let's open it.
From Bloody Bill. Who's that?
I'll get the tape player.
Aha. Chloe's dad is such a goofball.
That is so cool.
Ahoy there, plank walkers. It's me, Bloody Bill, the Pirate King.
What the heck?
By now you'll have seen that I dug up your treasure, which would normally make us mortal enemies. But hear me out. I haven't pilfered a thing. On the contrary. I figured you swashbucklers might not be back to your loot for some time, so I've given it extra protection from the winds and rain. I'm sure you're excited to open your time capsule, so I won't go on too long. Just know that Bloody Bill is bloody proud of you. Both of you. Keep those sails trimmed and that anchor scrubbed, and always remember... The real treasure is...
Friendship.
Love.
Your Oregon State prepaid college savings plan.
Ugh.
That's what we originally buried.
Huh, yeah. I guess it probably would have gotten ruined underground.
Holy crap! It's Billy the Squid! He's alive!
Oh, man!
It really is like a time capsule.
No way!
Chloe, Look at this. We wrote each other letters.
Oh, I remember these. To Chloe Price. Thanks, Max. I hope you are having a lot of fun being a teenager with your best friend. Aw, you are so cute. Check it out.
Ugh, Maxine.
How are you today? I'm doing very well. It's Friday, June 27, 2003. It is summer vacation. We're making a time capsule for you and me in the future. We're making a pirate theme. Wasn't it hilarious to find... These are some things we like. Favorite animal, Arabian horse. Max? And Chloe's favorite is the otter. Favorite food, lobster roll and coffee ice cream. Favorite class in school, art or library, science. Best friend, each other. How about you? Are you age 12 or more? What are your favorite foods, movies, etc.? That's all for now. I hope you're having a lot of fun being a teenager with your best friend.
How about mine? What did I write?
This is so Chloe.
Dear Maxine, hello from 2003. Here's a record of how we spend our days. Can you guess which one is real? We go to the same school and always sit together at lunch? Duh. We have sleepovers at least once a week. We like extremely salty pretzels. We are in a race to see who can convince your parents to get a pet first. We're going to live together when we can afford it and use only gold paint. We have battled many foes and never failed to save each other. What did you guess? If you guessed all of them, you are right. You are really both, actually. Let's go with sweet.
You were really sweet.
Oh man, I was really goopy.
I like it.
That's because you're a goop.
This is so cool. There's so much to look at.
Is your mom going to mind about this mess?
Dunno. I thought they'd be home by now.
Max, remember scratch art? Oh, I love this stuff.
I'm gonna draw something.
All these memories. I want to look at if this container looks like it could last 100 years.
Holy crap! It's the end of that comic in Chloe's room.
It's the last panel.
This is gross.
Maybe you should calm down and power off flight with this dude. With this dude's face off with me. Holy shit. Billy the Squid.
It's good to see you, old friend.
This is so cool. Oh, I like this so much.
Such a good idea. These are awesome. Chloe's always been good at making up cool things to do.
That is pretty cool. Flaming fingers. That idea is pretty cool as well. A ray of sunshine. With laser beams. Ah, that is so cool. Predictions? What's that?
Most of these are pretty far off base.
Predictions for the future. We still hang out with...
It's better to enjoy the present instead.
We still hang out with each other more than with any other person. Both of us are medium popular. Both of us are dating our second boyfriend. We do not make decisions without consulting each other. The taking skull of our enemies. Alright. The talking skull of our enemies. Both of us have a pet. Chloe has visited Antarctica. Max could have come if she wanted. One of us has a little sister or brother. We're doing well in school. Well. They do. So far, actually.
I love how Polaroid cameras make every photo look a little nostalgic.
That's actually right.
We always make so much more of a mess.
It's an anime magazine.
Manga might be the one thing where
it's a manga. All right. I thought it's a magazine about animes. Should we tidy this up a little bit? Let's tidy this up. I like doing household chores and video games because it's so quick.
Much better.
Somebody's a goody two-shoes.
What did you just say?
That was a good week. I used every possible excuse to be here for breakfast.
Good luck, hubby. We're so proud of your promotion. You get a week of two whales waffles in your own house. Cool.
I always look especially short next to Chloe.
I know how that feels. Believe me, I fucking do. Alright, I think we found everything. Oh, is that a video game? What are they playing?
Hey, what if my being in Seattle finally convinces Chloe to try an MMO?
No peeking at my work.
I wasn't.
Get out of here.
I wasn't.
Chloe
I swear.
And I spilled that wine months ago. But I still feel bad about it. You sure were troublesome to find. That's so cool that Chloe's mom is thinking about this.
What are you drawing? I see it. Ha!
Chloe looks so content when she's drawing. Is that what I look like when I'm taking pictures?
Yep, can confirm.
Looks like Chloe's a lot more responsible than I am with my allowance. I bet there's some really cute photos in there. I wonder if I could recreate this photo with Chloe now.
Yes, we will do this right now.
I wonder if I could recreate this photo with Chloe now.
I can see what you're doing.
Just don't move. The artist at work.
Or trying to work. Ah, keep messing up my picture.
There are no mistakes in art. Today's been awesome, huh?
For real. I love it when you stay over.
This used to be the rainy day pirate ship.
How can we, like, recreate this picture?
I wonder if I could recreate this photo with Chloe now.
I want to.
Is it weird how much I love looking through other people's photo albums?
Just a little bit.
Chloe and I have been friends for so long.
I like that Chloe's father's always
try talking to Chloe again about
in the middle of it.
News. I can do that after I finish. You're such a space hog. Move over.
Nope.
Right, that's enough. Oh, alright. I thought we're done in here, to be honest. Alright. Looks like we're not. I really want to recreate the photo with her.
Hey, hippie.
How's the masterpiece?
Working on the last bit. How about you? Done with the time capsule?
Yeah, I think we checked everything.
Yeah, I think so.
Well, perfect, because now I'm finished. Check it out.
This is so silly.
Jeez, this jawbreaker is going to last forever.
This jawbreaker is going to last forever?
Just like our friendship.
Oh, Chloe, you were really drawing me that whole time.
Whoa. Mushiness alert. Keep it together, Max.
I guess now's my chance to tell Chloe I'm leaving. We might not be alone again once her parents get back.
Hey, ready for something else? I've got a great plan for the afternoon.
Crap. I don't want to ruin the rest of the day.
You're staying for dinner, right?
Would Chloe even want me to tell her? She didn't seem to want to talk about anything serious upstairs.
Max?
It's just Seattle. I'm probably overstressing about the whole thing. Right?
We need to tell her. It's really.
Chloe?
Max?
I want to tell you something.
Okay.
My family's moving to Seattle really soon. Hey.
In 3 days, right?
What? You knew that?
Our parents do talk, you know?
But they said I should be the one to tell you.
They still told my parents. I guess Mom and Dad were trying to keep quiet too, but they're bad at hiding anything. Don't look so worried, Max. It's okay. Come on, Dorkmeister. It's not the end of the world.
Should have told you earlier.
I should have just told you earlier. I feel so stupid.
Max, I said it was okay.
I was trying to tell you this morning, but...
But I totally distracted you with the pirate tape. Success.
Seriously?
I didn't want this hanging over us all day. Plus, I know you hate this kind of conversation, so... I just left it alone, you know? Come on. I want to spend every minute we have together having fun.
We'll keep in touch and visit. I'm worried I won't be okay. We'll keep in touch.
We should.
Well, we know it's not gonna happen.
And maybe we'll move back. Who knows?
Chill out. We can go to college together. It's gonna be fine. We're Max and Chloe, remember? We're always together. Even when we're not.
That's true.
Cool. Let's find something fun to do.
That's the day it happened.
We are to know. Winter stole summer's thrill, and the river's cracked and cold. See, the sky is no man's land, a dark and plumed estate. Hope here needs a humble hand, not a fox found in your place.
Holy shit. I wasn't aware that city. I actually thought this happened after she moved away already.
Can't you see, oh, or maybe you were the ocean when I was just a stone. Black flies on the windowsill. That we are to hold. Comfort came against my will, and every story must grow old. Still I'll be a traveler, a gypsy's reins to face. But the road is wearier with that fool found in your place. No man is an island, or this I know. But can't you see, or maybe you were the ocean when I was just a
They left on the same fucking day. Really? Holy shit, like on the day when... Fuck. I should have waited a few days or something.
Thinking if I could just see you, but we'll get good at it, great at it. We'll write and talk all the time, and then you'll come visit, and it'll be like I never left. I mean it. You don't have to worry about anything changing. You're dealing with so much other stuff. You don't deserve any of this. Chloe, listen, even if we're moving for good, we are always together, okay? Even when we're apart, we're still Max and Chloe. I will always, always love you.
Oh, come on, that was it, really? Oh, shit. Holy fucking shit. Almost got a little teary-eyed there. Almost. Almost. Damn, you can't end this on me like this. This is so... Shit, I thought this is the last time Like, they have a little bit fun and everything will be fine. I wasn't aware that it's going to end like this. Seriously, I wasn't aware of that. And actually, I wasn't aware that it was... like, there was such little time between, like, her father dying and Max leaving. It's 3 days. In 3 days, she lost her father and her best friend. Which is really hard. Because, like, we know, unfortunately, despite everything Max said, we know that they lost contact. Until the first Life is Strange started again, and when Max moved back. Holy shit, I wasn't prepared for that. Yeah, actually, I don't really know what to say about this. This closed, for me, the last gap. It was really, really cool to play. I thought it's going to be longer, like, I'm playing now for 1 hour 20. But yeah, I think it was enough. It was definitely enough. And I don't know if there's actually a decision screen, probably not, because there weren't really decisions in this game. But yeah, I don't really know what to say about this. I really don't know more to say about it. It was so cool. Like, they had such a fun day. Like, half a fun day. Oh boy. Well, yeah. I would say that we will, if there's a decision screen, I will see you there. Otherwise, I will see you after the credits again. Alright, there's no decision screen. I thought so, because like, yeah, there weren't really any decisions in there. But I thought about it like while the credits were running, and what I now finally understood is one thing. Chloe was a grade A student, she was happy with her life, with school, with everything. But then, what I really wasn't aware, like, that those two things were that close. Like I said, within 3 fucking days, she lost her father and her best friend. And that's really something. I can now fully understand what changed her soul. Because, again, despite any promises that from Max, they weren't talking anymore, like not for long. And they completely lost touch. And yeah, Chloe just didn't deal with it very well. She was destroyed by losing her father and then not having her friend talking to her anymore. I kinda understand that now. I really gotta say that. So yeah, I was hoping for a little more cheerful episode as an end to this let's play. But yeah. Anyway, I really hope that you enjoyed it. I did. I definitely did, despite how it turned out. It was important. For me, it was an important thing to finally see. Like, you saw fragments of it, but never the whole plot. Like, for me, I never understood that it's so close together, those two things. So yeah, again, I really hope that you enjoyed it. If you did, hit the like button down below, leave me a comment, and I really hope that there's more Life is Strange that they're working on. I have to admit, like, I haven't read any news about this so far. Maybe there was an announcement with the release of the final bonus episode. Now, I don't know. Since I was sick, or I'm still a little bit, as you can still hear. I don't know. But I really hope so, and if so, we will play it. And yeah. Again, hope you enjoyed it. And then I will see you again in the next video. So, see ya.